talk about ethics, then we have to talk about trust. And I think the majority of benefits come from trust side, because selling fuel and food, it's important to earn customers' trust. And another thing, also our partners have to trust us, and then this ethics code of conduct makes sure that customers and partners can trust us, and this makes them more loyal. Having more loyal customers and also loyal partners is usually financially beneficial. I think it's important to mention that Statoil started in Estonia in 1991, and already in 1995 was introduced the first ethics code of conduct. And we inherited it from our mother company, Statoil Asaven. And it was mostly created because Statoil Asa wanted to enter to new markets. And they wanted to make sure that this so-called very famous Nordic business culture will be introduced also those areas they work. So it was first when we started to work with this ethics code of conduct, it was very, let's say, strange to our partners, because we tried to include it to all agreements. But in real life, it's very simple document. It describes simply how we work with our partners, with local authorities, with our employees. So it's everybody in company knows, and also our partners know what to expect and what we do and what we don't do. It makes it easier for our employees to make decisions everyday life. We try to add this ethics code of conduct to our all agreements, and it has helped us to pick the right business partners, because they also have to sign it. And in many cases, when we have evaluated our potential partners, something tricky pops up. Or another way, we have also had the cases when the partner has said that they are not able to sign it. And I think it's very honest from where to say that they are simply not ready to sign that kind of ethics code of conduct. But another way, we have been sure that there is no surprises, negative surprises from our partners. No cost involved with clearing some strange situations or having the surprise not being able to get the services or products from the partner who has either bankrupt or have been a part of corruption or other illegal activities. As I said, the ethics code of conduct is really, really simple documents, and everybody can easily understand what is where. So I recommend other companies also to create similar document. Maybe the ethics code of conduct sounds very professional or something big, but even a small described process is help our employees to make their decisions easier and avoid these conflict moments where we have to kind of have dilemmas, either to do that or something else. So in my eyes, it improves also the speed of processes inside the company.